All right, cool. Don't think anybody has any questions about that, so I'm going to go ahead and move on to my next topic, which was how I build my packing list. So I'm going to try to do this without giving away the outfits that I'm doing for the debt parties. But I've started building my packing list, and when I first started doing these vlogs, I got so many questions about what to pack. I felt bad because I wasn't comfortable answering them yet because I hadn't even started to kind of wrap my mind around my own packing list, let alone helping you guys figure out your packing situation. And I think I mentioned to everybody else that, that I wanted to wait for the debt parties to come out before I started my packing list. So, let's go ahead and get into it. So basically, I'm super organized, guys. Like, I just, especially when it comes to traveling, I've traveled a lot, and you would think that, like, I could be one of those people who could just throw things in a bag and go and probably not forget anything because I've traveled so much. But when it comes to these Backstreet Boys cruises, guys, if I forgot even, like, the smallest thing, I just know that it would ruin my trip. I would just be in a bad mood every time I thought about that one item that I forgot. And probably the most important item are going to be my travel documents. So that's why, like, my first section of my packing list, which, I'm not going to flash it on the screen because somebody could get smart and just hit the pause button once the video is up. Y'all tried it. Not going to happen. So let me just tell you guys what's on this list. At the top of the list, I basically put it into sections. The first section is documents. So that's going to be my passport and my driver's license. Although if I have my passport to get on board, I don't really need my driver's license, but like, who leaves the house without the driver's license? My credit card, pretty much just my wallet. But like, a lot of times when I'm traveling, I'll either take a smaller wallet than my regular everyday wallet, and I'll like empty it out, and I know myself, I could literally forget to pack my credit card and whatever consolidated wallet that I bring. So I write it down. So passport, driver's license, credit card, and then the documents that I'm able to get once I'm able to check in on Carnival's website, which again, Rose Tours will send you the link to do that about 2 weeks before we sail away. And those items that I'm going to go ahead and pre-print are going to be my boarding pass and my luggage tag. And what I usually bring with me is, because like I said, I'm over-organized. You guys don't have to do this. But I usually bring like a little file folder thing, and I put like all of like my paper documents in that so they stay nice and neat. And I'll go ahead and pre-print my boarding pass. Now, I think it was Tracy Carr who mentioned that I know for sure Marriott Biscayne Bay, and I'm sure pretty much any hotel either has a business center or they'd be willing to print something for you at the front desk if you want to wait until you get to Miami to print off your cruise docs. And that's fine. You guys can do that. I don't want to leave it to chance, because what happens if you get to Marriott Biscayne Bay and they're like, oh, wouldn't you know it, our printer's broken. Or, I don't know, the business center's out of order. Or everybody and their mother who's staying at that hotel also needs to print cruise documents. And it's just, that's just time spent waiting to print something that you could have printed at home or printed at work or like gone to Kinko's real quick and printed off. So I'd like to get to Miami with my cruise documents, my boarding pass, and my luggage tags already printed off. As I mentioned before, I also like to bring either some tape or like a baby stapler with me, so that when I'm in the hotel room the night before, I'll probably go ahead at that point and put my luggage tags on my luggage, so that when I get to the port, luggage tags are already on. I can just hand them to the porter. I pre-fill out my luggage tags like when I print them, just because it's like, meh, like that's it's real, guys. My luggage tags are printed. I'm going on a cruise with the Backstreet Boys. I get like, it's all on the shoulders, guys. Just, if you want to be this cool, those are things that you should know. But yeah, so I have a section for documents. And the things that are on there again are my passport, my driver's license, my credit card, boarding pass, and luggage tags. So The next thing that I do is I make a section for any technology items that I'm going to need. So I probably am not going to bring my MacBook, but I probably will be bringing my iPad because I'll be vlogging. I'm going to bring my phone. I don't want to forget my charger. I don't want to forget my charging case. So basically, I don't have it on there right now because I'm actually looking for a new and better one. I like to use the cases that you can put on your phone, like the case that you can actually charge, so that that way, if you're out and about and you're being mobile, as you typically are with a mobile phone, and you start to notice that your battery power is lagging, you can just press a little button on that case and it'll start charging your phone, which is really convenient for the cruise. That way you don't have to spend any time running your phone back to the cabin to let it charge. If you do find yourself in that situation, or even if you've got the charging case on it and you just want to charge your phone as quickly as possible, a trick that you guys can use, I don't know if it works for Android or not because I have an iPhone, but first thing you want to do is you want to make sure that you close all of your apps out. So, and obviously I am bad at this today. Got a lot of stuff open. Okay, so close all of your apps out and then put your phone into airplane mode. It'll actually charge faster. And if you are out and about, like on board the ship, and you don't want your phone to be eating a bunch of battery life, make sure that you keep all those windows closed that you're not using, because if those windows, if those apps are open, even if you're not actually using them, they're running in the background and sucking battery life out of your phone. So pro tip there, but yeah, just that way I don't forget any of the technological items that I'm going to need while I'm on the cruise. So that's technology items. The rest of my packing list, I actually go ahead and still, I put it into categories, and I put it into categories by when I'm going to need said item. So I will have like a packing list for, even though technically it's not getting packed because it's what I'm going to wear to the airport to travel down to Miami, I will have like my outfit planned. Like I'm telling you, like I'm a little extra, so you guys don't have to do all these things, but they just help me. I plan what I'm going to wear to the airport. I live in Atlanta. There is a chance that Brian could be flying out of Atlanta. There is a chance that any one of the boys could have a connecting flight out of Atlanta. You better trust and believe it's just going to be looking good to make the flight down to Miami from Atlanta, because you just never know who you're going to run into in the Atlanta airport, and I'm just going to be fly. So I'm going to be fly at the airport. If I didn't have a boyfriend, I'm pretty sure I would know that I'm going to die alone. Because I'm a walking, talking dad joke. You guys do realize that, right? And like, my boyfriend already knows this. Like, when we get married and have kids, he's going to be the father, but I'm totally going to be the dad. Like, when it comes to the dad jokes, I got tons of them. Awesome, Sarah. So you get me. I'm a list maker. I have a list going right now for, you guys can't see that, but this is all the things that I've already ordered for deck parties that I'm waiting to be, like, that have been shipped already. And I'm like tracking, like, what day are they coming? Who's the carrier? I don't like to leave things to chance when I can help it. So, thanks, Rabia. That's really sweet. It's not true, but it's really sweet. But anyway, yeah, so I make lists for everything, including what I'm going to wear to the airport. And then I continue my packing list. Okay, the next day it's going to be getting up and sailing away. This also helps me to pack things in the order that I'm going to need them. Because I'm not the kind of person, even when I'm like, I went to Dominican Republic in July and we were there for like a week. We were there for like 8 days, I think. I don't unpack and like hang things up. I just literally live out of the luggage. So I like to pack things in the order that I know that I'm going to need to encounter them as I'm digging through things, so that I'm not making a total catastrophe out of the packing that I did. So I will make this list and then pack it backwards. So last things I'm going to need at the bottom and then work my way up so that as I encounter them, I'm getting them as I need them. So outfit for sail away. The makeup, that of course my makeup is all gonna live in the same place. But just, you know, making sure that I have everything that I need for the makeup for whatever look I'm going for. That gets particularly important for deck parties. So to make sure that I've brought all of everything that I'm gonna be using, because I am gonna touch on that a little bit later. I wanted to discuss some makeup favorites with you guys, particularly when it comes to makeup for deck parties. And I also wanna share with you guys something that I just discovered that I cannot wait to try myself, because I've never actually used it, but I've watched a few different YouTube tutorials on it, and this product seems awesome, so I'm gonna share it with you guys. So yeah, making sure that I've got all my makeup for all my looks. And then from there, I pretty much just pack according to the order of the deck parties. And then, of course, I make sure that I have an outfit in there for whatever I'm gonna wear to leave the ship. I'm going to have whatever I plan to wear for the beach party or the pool party or whatever it is that we end up doing. And then just general outfits to wear when it's not time to be really extra, like at a deck party. So like just everyday outfits, because that will be the case too on the ship. We've got 2 fun days at sea. You still can't just be walking around naked. I mean, I don't know if it's international law. Maybe you can, but I just, you know, I wouldn't. So yeah, that's how I build my packing list. I have already started it, but I'm going to finalize it. I'm going to redo this packing list once I've really tried everything on for the deck parties and stuff. But I'm going to wait till we get the full itinerary, because again, I'm an organizational nightmare. I am extra. I'm going to pack according to what's on that actual itinerary. So like, depending on when my photo group has their photo day with the boys and whatever outfit I decide I'm going to wear in my photo, that's going to have to go in there, and I'm going to make sure that like I have it, you know, have it however I need it. But like, one of the things that I do for this, for my packing list is, you guys can't see that, thank God. I itemize everything in the list. Like one category will be deck party costume, high school night. And I'll bullet point all of the items that I'll need, like literally every item down to the shoes. I will make a separate list for, I've actually started that separate list for the makeup looks that are gonna accompany each of those deck party outfits, so that I know which makeup items I need to make sure that I have that are currently in my collection, and what items I actually need to buy. And I have a separate list that's written down for items that I need to buy. And as I get them, I'm just crossing them off of the list. So yeah, so that's how I build my packing list. Does anyone have any questions about packing? There he is. Well, I'm waiting to see if you guys have more packing questions. That's the monster who stole my AirPod. He looks all innocent. He's being quiet. He's giving me the kitten eyes. Yeah, okay. What lurks beneath is a demon. Who cares? Nothing for mommy's pocketbook, because now I have to go buy new ones. No, yeah, you're right. And then, but then he plays like he's a little coward. So you guys, when Kara Lee was here on Saturday, Bellatrix is like how she always is. Whenever I have people over, she's like the official greeter. She's like, how are you doing? So nice to meet you. Love me, love me. Rigel couldn't be bothered. He's hiding under the bed. Yeah. Hi, Erica. You don't want me to do your makeup. So I'm one of those people who, like, I can do my own makeup. And I can do a little bit on other people. But for some reason, like, I just, like, there's certain things that I can do to my own face. And, like, if I poke myself in the eye with the mascara or with the eyeliner thing, I poked myself in the eye. But if I poke you in the eye, like, I will just feel terrible and you'll be blind. So we don't want any of that. No, I promise you don't. And I also, so if I agree to do your makeup, then I'm sure there's going to be a ton of other people asking me to do their makeup. And guys, I'm a nice person, I promise. But I, like, on the cruise, like, I gotta have time to do my own makeup and, like, you know, be weird with Kevin. Like, it's, that's not gonna happen on its own, guys. I gotta actually be there with him to be weird and be uncomfortable and awkward. So, yeah.